Darkness is coming! Darkness is coming! Darkness is coming! Darkness is coming! Darkness is coming!
Do you fear the dark? Do you fear the endless night? Do you fear the coming terror?
We fear the dark! We fear the endless night! We fear the coming terror! Darkness is coming! Darkness is coming! Darkness is coming!
Do you hunger for the light? Do you despair at the emptiness? Is all hope lost?
We hunger for the light! We despair the emptiness! All hope is lost! Darkness is coming! Darkness is coming! Darkness is coming!
Don't you understand? It doesn't have to be this way! There is hope! There is light! There is love!
We understand! It must be this way! There is no hope! There is no light! There is no love! Darkness is coming! Darkness is coming! Darkness is coming!
No, it's not true! She denies the darkness!
She denies the darkness! The darkness cannot be denied!
No!
She must be cleansed! She must have fear! She must have darkness!
Please, please don't!
Cleanse!
Cleanse! Cleanse! Cleanse!
Leave me alone, please!
It must be done!
I'm sorry, Neil. Can we just stop for a second?
What is it now, Emily?
It's just... Do you not think it's a bit much?
What do you mean?
I mean, the opera, the thunder and lightning, the knives.
Yeah?
Well...
Go on.
It's only A-level theatre studies.
Take five, everyone. Now, what's really the problem here? You don't like my script?
No, it's great. I love the script.
It's a great script, Neil. Great script.
Cheers, Dave.
All I'm saying is, it's so intense. I mean, a murder on page one. How do you follow that?
Well, it's the orgy next, isn't it?
Thanks, Kate. That's right. Act one, scene two. The orgy in the House of Parliament.
Love it. Love the orgy. In the script, I mean, not in general.
Murder, sex, and that's just act one.
It's done on tableau, though, so it's not as bad.
Yeah, tableau sex, best kind.
Oh, I'm just saying.
Look, we're performing this next Monday. You've got plenty of time to raise any objections. Now, unless you're suggesting I rewrite the entire thing from scratch...
I'm not. I'm just saying.
What?
Mr. Henderson says we've just got to tick the boxes and we'll get an A.
That's true.
Look, I've got the examiner requirements here. It says that candidates must devise... There. Candidates must devise a piece of theatre in a selected performance style, which demonstrates their knowledge, understanding and practical competence in incorporating features of that style into their piece.
Yes, yeah, so?
So, what style are we? We need one.
What styles are there?
There's loads. Epic, docudrama, Brechtian, Grotowski, physical theatre.
Oh, please.
Which style are we then?
We're a bit Brecht, I think. Maybe a bit physical.
What's Brecht again?
Oh, that's where it's like really bad, but for some reason also good.
Oh, yeah, they're from Jung's Effect.
What does that mean?
No idea.
Is Stanislavski a style? Was it just a Baroque?
Method acting.
What's that?
That's where you act like a dick for the entire time, then win an Oscar.
We're our style. We don't need to conform to some fidgety old fart's concept of what makes good theatre. We create as we go. We're original. And in my book, that counts for a lot more than ticking boxes.
Okay, but...
Are you guys finished? We need the room.
In a minute. Emily, you were saying?
Just maybe we could take it down a notch.
Take it down a notch? Take it down a notch?
Go on.
Did Shakespeare take it down a notch? Did Bennett? Did Pindar? Well, did they?
No.
Could you hurry up? We really need to practice.
Rehearse! It's not supposed to be comfortable. It's not supposed to be easy. If you can't handle it, then I suggest you go work with the other group. I believe they're doing a Simply Charming play on homelessness or something. Do you want that?
No.
I'm sorry, I didn't hear you.
I said no.
Good. You two got anything to say?
No, boss.
No.
Good.
Guys.
Okay, we're done. Have you...
Guys, can we keep the PDAs to an absolute minimum, please?
Sorry, Derek.
I know, sorry. I just can't keep my hands off her.
Stop it! No, seriously, get off!
What are you looking at?
Nothing.
or leave Neil alone is a sensible story. Isn't that right?
We need to start. What's your play called again? Private Parts.
Sorry, Private
Parts.
Some title.
Yeah, why not go the whole hog and call it Dicks and Fannies?
It's an exploration of modern gender roles. Folks in the movie force people into strict gender roles based on performativity of homogenous societal norms.
Sounds political?
It is.
What style is it?
Feminist.
You got something to say, Neil?
Sorry? Oh, no, nothing. I just think it's, well...
What?
I think your thinking is clearly disordered.
Disordered?
Performativity of gender roles. Lot of nonsense. All these men you claim to be repressing you, and the rest of humankind. Who brought them up? Women. Mothers. Grandmothers. Aunts. Nannies. Women. There's no such thing as patriarchy. It's matriarchy that's the problem.
Wow. That is wrong in so many ways, and offensive in so many other ways.
Tell me I'm wrong, I tell you. This society's got it all wrong. Women aren't repressed. They aren't discriminated
against. Maybe shut up,
man. They're free to do whatever they like.
Damn right. And this woman is saying, shut up, sod off, and let us practice. Okay? Okay? Good. Now off your sod, all of you.
You okay, buddy?
I think I'm in love. Small one, some as big as your head. Give him a twist, a flick of the wrist. That's what the showman said. Oh, I've got a lovely bunch of... What? Oh, come on, don't look at me like that.
What are you doing?
Oh, you know, I was watching from the side and was moved to join in. Or, how would you put it, Amy? Confirm my gender role in a structuralist pantomime of femininity.
Why are you wearing a bra?
Hey!
For fun?
That's my bra!
Is it? Are you sure?
What the hell are you doing wearing my bra?
Oh, this is your bra. I just found it.
Where?
Oh, around.
He's been going through her stuff. Not cool, man. Not cool at all.
Chill your boots. I haven't been going through your stuff. This is on a pile of clothes when we came to change. I saw it and thought, what the hell?
Take it off now.
Take it off?
Take. It. Off.
Right. Okay. Ah. I seem to be having a little trouble with the... Come on, you little...
one of you wouldn't mind. Wouldn't mind.
What the hell is going on?
Ah, Dave, hello. I seem to be having a little trouble with the...
Oh, for God's sake.
There you go. Thanks, Derek. How did you learn that?
How did you practice, though?
Rehearsal!
It was going fine until Neil roomed our final run-through.
Yeah, well, we booked the room from three, so if you lot could just...
Yeah, all right. I think we'll do it at the desk anyway. Just give her a second to paddle.
Do you think you're ready for the exam tomorrow?
I hope so. All a bit scary. You'll be fine. It's just the idea of the exam that's sitting right there. Gives us the willies. You're really good. Oh, thanks. So are you? Good, I mean the place good, I mean. You know what I mean. Yeah, thanks.
So, are you still coming tonight?
Yeah.
Oh, should be a good one. Hey, check it out. My brother bought it for me for finishing school.
Shit, put that away. What if Mr. Henderson sees?
Chill. He'll probably be into it. I reckon he was a proper rocker back in the day.
Oh, please. Nigel would never drink to excess.
Nigel? What's with Nigel? Call him Mr. Henderson, you bummer. Oh, sorry, Derek. Forgot you were here.
It's fine.
So, what's going on tonight?
Big party at Mark's. End of exams and that. There's only tomorrow left. Everyone else is finished.
Oh, cool.
We'll all be there.
You're welcome to come too, Dave. You too, Kate, and... Yeah.
Oh, come on. Neil can come too, right, Mark?
Well, I suppose so.
Oh, well, I might drop by. I mean, I've got friends coming by, but yeah, sure, maybe later.
Right.
Will you be there, Lisa?
I might be.
Interesting, interesting. Maybe you and me could get some one-on-one time.
Ooh. In your dreams. Right, ready?
Yeah, see you all tonight.
We'll go and get changed.
So, you like Lisa now?
Yeah, girl's got spirit. A feisty one, she is.
Yoda talk. It must be love. But I thought you liked,
What?
I thought you liked Emily. What the hell does that mean?
Many fingers, many pies.
Oh, you're disgusting.
Hey.
Hey, did you forget something?
No, actually, I want to just talk to you.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, well, this part tonight. I'm sorry, this is a little awkward.
What?
Well, I thought you might want to go with me.
Oh, right, you mean you and me, like a date, together?
Yeah, I've been watching you from afar, and I've fallen deeply and desperately in love with you. I can't get you out of my head. I think about you 24/7. And when you sleep, I hope you think about me constantly. And I hope your conscience eats at you, and you can't breathe without me.
Oh. That's Eminem. Oh, you're having me on.
Yes, Neil. I'm having you on. Don't be surprised to learn, not every gay man spends his nights lusting after straight boys with narcissistic complexes. No, I just thought it might be nice, that's all.
Oh, okay then. Derek, why did you ask me that? Like, instead of the others?
I'm just being nice, Neil. There's no ulterior motive.
Oh, okay. It's just, if you're not in love with me...
Which I'm not. Hard to believe. I know.
Yeah, if you're not that, then why ask me?
Because, well, I don't mean this in a bad way, but you don't seem to have any friends.
Oh, well, why would I think that would be bad?
Come on, Neil. We've known each other almost all our lives. Our parents know each other. And throughout all that time, you've never really had any friends.
Dave, Kate, Emily.
They're just schoolmates. When was the last time you spoke to them outside of school? Outside of drama? Drama's weird. You get lost in this world. Putting on a play. It's like fleeting, you know? Dave, Kate, Emily. After all this is over, they'll be gone.
You know?
What?
Nothing.
No. Go on.
Well, you're a nice guy, Derek. But if I were gay, and I'm not. But if I were, and I'm not. I wouldn't be so obvious about it. It wouldn't be the most interesting thing about me. I wouldn't talk such shit all the time. And I'd be more than just a faggot.
You pretentious little dick! I should fucking kill you!
Oh!
Enough, ah! Derek! Enough!
What the hell's going on?
That's right! Just flounce off like a little girl! Oh, my face! My pretty face!
What was all that about? What did you say to him?
Nothing!
You must have said something.
Who knows? Drama, baby, just drama!
chug, 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 chug.
Fuck! Woo! Yeah!
You're a monster, girl. Okay, now you, Emily.
I'd rather not.
Go on, get you good and pissed.
But the exam is tomorrow. I don't want to be hungover.
It's not until the afternoon. You'll be all right by then. Full English and a Red Bull, you'll be all right.
Oh, I really don't want to.
Don't make Emma.
Come on, we've all done it. Chug,
chug, chug,
chug, chug, chug, chug, chug, chug, chug, chug, chug. Oh, that's my girl.
I'll get it.
Now, who wants a sip of my magic bottle of chuckles? All right, fans, don't crowd me. Amy, don't you want some?
I'm not drinking that.
Go on, it'll loosen you up. It's only 65%.
God, you sound like one of them lads, you know, at the beginning of one of them episodes of the films we show at school.
What do you mean?
You know, the plausible nice guy out to corrupt the minds and bodies of innocent young women.
Oh, thanks.
It's not a good thing. I'll just have a beer.
Ems, how about you?
Yeah, okay. Beer too, then.
Look who I found!
Oh, great.
I brought wine.
Be sure to chill that. It's absolutely pissed at room temperature. And make sure you serve it in a large glass. Helps enliven the nose.
Hang on, mate.
£9 that cost me. Philistines will probably mix it with lemonade.
Guys, get over here. We're drinking like it's the end of the universe.
What happened to your face?
I walked into a door.
Not what we heard.
Are you going to drink that or review for the Times? Woo!
I mean, in your play, the influence of a number of thinkers is clear. Ivan C., Judith Butler, Eve Sedgwick, and Sylvia Plath. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah, Sylvia Plath. Got you.
Do you want to kiss me?
Okay. Wait, what am I doing? Why am I kissing you?
At the top of my head, I can think of six. No, seven main arguments for. One...
Shut up.
Thank you.
It's all good, yeah?
You just put whiskey in my drink. I feel absolutely off my face.
Don't fight it, just go with it.
I don't want to just go with it. I don't want to be on it at all.
Come here, kiss me.
Oh, you're no use. You're totally out of it.
I spiked Amy's drink too. Look at her. She seems to be having a great time.
I'm going home.
No, babe, come on.
Oh, no, don't touch me.
Jesus. Oh, didn't see that coming.
Oh, hi, Derek.
Hi.
Missed it last night.
Wasn't here. Decided to stay home. Learn my lines, you know?
You know, everyone was pretty out of it. Stuck to beer, so I'm alright. Had a nice sleep in his mum's bed. She's got really interesting taste in wall hangings. Where is Reynolds anyway?
Grand Canary, I think.
Oh, nice. What time is it?
It's past 11.
Oh, shit, the exam is at 2.
I know. No one turned up for registration, so I thought I'd pop by. Was Neil here?
Yeah, don't know where he's got to, though. Derek, it was shitty what he did.
It was shitty what I did.
Yeah, but also pretty funny.
You're a good guy, Dave. Now, to business. Mark.
What is this?
You need to take a shower. You really need to take a shower.
What time is it?
Past 11.
Oh, bollocks.
Wake up. Everyone, wake up. Wake up. Amy, wake up.
Oh, shit. Did you all just sleep?
Massively. Come on, we've got to get to college.
Look, I think I'm still drunk.
I spiked your drink with the whiskey, that's probably why.
What?
I did it at Emily too, but I can't find her. My parents are back tonight. I need to clear this up. Bin bags.
You alright?
I can't believe you did that. Spiked us.
Didn't make a fool of yourself, did you?
Excuse me. Amy?
You just missed her.
Oh, okay. Oh, shit!
Come on, you need to make a move. I've got to clear up.
I'll give you a hand.
Okay, well, see you later.
Hold on, I'll come with you.
Where have you two been?
The thing is, I know, I'm sorry. I had a thing.
What sort of thing?
I'll tell you about it later. Is everyone ready?
Everyone except Emily.
Where is she?
Breaking up with Mark. He spiked her drink last night.
Wow, that's...
Yeah, heavy.
Have you had a look out there yet?
Yeah, your mum and dad are in the front row.
Oh, typical. Ah, yes. Hello, mummy.
Hello, daddy.
Which one's the examiner?
The woman who looks a bit like a chicken. So sit next to Nigel. Mr. Henderson.
Oh, yes. I see her. Excellent. Think you're ready?
It was really stupid getting drunk last night. Really, really stupid. This stuff's important, and we're doing it with a hangover.
Hangover? Pah!
Really?
Never had one myself. I hear they're intense.
They are. I've just threw up in the girls' loo.
Emily, finally.
Sorry.
You can't muck about with this stuff. This counts. Do you want to go to Cardiff University? Because that's where you're heading if we mess this up.
What's wrong with Cardiff?
Oh, please.
Are you okay?
I'm fine. No, really, I'm fine. Dickhead had it coming, right?
Right. No use crying over spilt dickheads. Just gotta get on with it. I'm running. 2 minutes. Right, you lot, you all get your knives. Excellent. Now, I'm not one for speeches. But I'd just like to say, after all the hard work, after all the tears, fallings out, affairs, bust-ups, and screaming tantrums, you can put your knives away now. After everything we've been through, you must remember one thing and one thing alone, that it was worth it. Why? Because you are actors. You are the vanguard that exists at the very zenith between fact and fiction. You are actors, the chosen few. Now go out there and make me proud. Okay, was expecting an applause then, but... Okay. Everyone ready?
Yeah.
I think so.
I was born ready! Sorry, I'm nervous.
Okay, everyone, good luck. On we go. Oh, Lisa.
You coming?
1 second. So.
So?
Last night.
Yeah, last night.
I'm sorry I had to leave in such a rush. There were things I wanted to tell you. Things I've been burning to say to you ever since I laid eyes on your sweet face.
Me too. Listen, Neil.
The thing is, I'm a little pressed for time right now, so if you wouldn't mind waiting a teeny bit longer.
No, Neil, I need to talk to you right now.
Right now?
Yeah.
Neil!
I'll be there in a minute! So, last night.
Yeah, last night. It was...
amazing.
Yeah. But, I think, Neil, it'll be best if we just stay friends and not, you know, complicate things.
Oh?
Derek and Mark know, but they've promised to keep it quiet. I don't want you to tell anyone else. You haven't told anyone, have you?
No, but why?
Why what?
Why can't we celebrate our love?
Love. That wasn't love. I was just really drunk and... oh, what am I doing? I can't lie to you.
Oh?
Neil, Mr. Henderson wants to start.
In a minute, Nigel! You were saying something about lying?
Yeah. I don't want to be your girlfriend, but I also don't want to be your friend either.
Right.
The truth is, I can't stand you. You're a moron. A complete cretin. I don't think I've ever met someone so insensitive, arrogant, and completely up his own arse.
Right.
And nothing. That's it. I hate you and everything you stand for, so I won't be shagging you again. Last night was the worst mistake of my life, and I'll live with it until I die. Okay.
Okay. So definitely no chance of more sex then.
Good luck with the play, Neil. You're completely talentless, waste of space, tosser. And you're terrible at sex.
Neil!
Yeah, coming.
Us next.
Yeah. Are you guys nervous?
Petrified.
outside, and my head feels like someone's been kicking it with a pair of Doc Martin boots for 5 hours. Yeah, thanks for that, Ma.
Hey, I said I'm sorry, didn't I? I'm paying for it. Emily dumped me.
I'm not surprised. It was a violation. Anything could have happened. People could have got hurt.
All right, all right.
It's finished. Get it, Mom.
How did it go?
Good, I think.
Good. We bloody killed it out there. Massacred them in their sleep. Come on, let's take a curtain call.
But the stop capping. You can't go on in silence.
I don't give a damn. I'll go back on if I want.
Neil, no.
Wow, he's really doing it.
Oh God, I can't watch. What's he doing?
Just sort of standing there. There's still some people clapping. Oh, it's his mum and dad.
What's happening now?
He's shaking hands with Mr. Henderson. And oh God, Neil, don't do it!
No!
What is it?
I cannot believe you did that.
What did he do?
He kissed the examiner.
On the cheek?
On the mouth? For a disturbingly long time.
What is wrong with you?
Hey, don't judge me. You of all people.
What's that supposed to mean?
I'll tell you what it means, slut.
Neil!
Me and Lisa did it last night. Full sex. The whole caboodle. Intercourse. Yes, sexual intercourse.
Really got to get ready. What on next?
Yeah, you guys, get out of here.
Okay, come on, Romeo.
Hey, Emily, come. Oh shit, babe.
I don't remember much about last night. Oh yeah, you didn't miss much. I know what happened between us. Ah, yeah. Well. I was all drunk because Mark spiked my drink, and I don't regret it. Amy, I don't regret it. I want to see you again. Really. But now I've really got to go. Okay, break the leg.
I can't believe you slept with Neil.
Can't believe you punched him?
Touché. Good luck.
You too.
And to you, my dear.
Mostly. Played some GTA.
Not that much, actually.
Still in love with Emily?
Yeah, she doesn't forgive me.
Neither do I.
Yeah. I was hoping
to see her a day. Yeah, she'll be here in a minute.
Oh, okay, cool.
Got your envelope?
Nothing matters. My dad's got me a job at him.
Doing what?
Finance or something.
Lucky?
Maybe.
What's up, bitches?
Hello, you got your results?
Got them right here. 3 C's, I'm going to Cardiff.
Well, we're supposed to open them all together. Who else is coming? Sorry, Molly.
It's okay, we haven't started yet. Whoa. When did this happen?
Where have you been, the moon?
Prom. It happened at the prom and we couldn't be happier. It's due next March. That would be a joke.
Hilarious.
Cheers.
Hi, everyone.
Hi.
Hi.
Hey, Emily.
Hi, Ma. How you been?
Okay, listen. I was thinking that...
Come on. No time for that. Everyone's here. Let's get on.
On three.
One, two, three.
Brilliant.
Swap.
Did anyone fuck up? Did we all manage it? Yeah,
well, really well.
Mark, you all right? Mark, 3 years, that's fantastic.
Doesn't matter.
Your dad, right?
Hey, doesn't want me to go. Wants me to stay with him.
You don't have to do what he says, you know.
Yeah, I do. Emily, listen. Do you think there's any chance...
No, Mark. No chance. Sorry.
I love you, though.
Come on. Come and celebrate.
Hey, look what I got.
Hey, Neil. What have you been up to all summer, mate?
Oh, you know, this and that.
Sorry I haven't called.
Don't worry, I get it. It's your Lisa now.
What?
You and Lisa, you're a thing, right?
Oh, well, yeah, I would have told you, man. You were AWOL.
Yeah, no worries.
Wait.
All hail Macbeth! Hail to thee, Thane of Clans! All hail Macbeth! Hail to thee, Thane of Cawdor!
Neil!
All hail Macbeth! Thou shalt be king hereafter!
So how are you all doing? I take it the champagne in success.
Yeah, well, Paul did really well.
How did you do, Neil?
Sorry?
Your results?
Oh, yeah. Fine, thanks. I got everything I needed.
Let's see.
No! No! That's private! That's private!
Relax! I said you did fine, right?
Yeah.
So let's see. Oh.
It's fine.
What is
Neil?
It?
What's wrong?
You failed for your studies? Badly?
Shit, really?
Dude, chill.
Oh, Neil. You've really messed up.
You think I don't know that?
But
nothing. I'm screwed. I needed a B to get my place.
What did you write? In the exam, what did you do?
Try to be clever. Attack the question. Call it stupid. Stuff like that. Guess they didn't find it funny.
What are you...
What am I going to do? Sod all. That's what I'm going to do. I'm not going to uni. I'm not getting a job. I'm not doing anything. I'm screwed. My life's ruined.
Well,
yes, it
not.
Is, Emily. Yes, it is. And you know what? Do you know what the worst thing is? I don't give a toss about these stupid, bloody results. I was just excited to see you all day. You know, my friends. You've got no idea.
No idea what?
What it's like to be so lonely. And none of you, not even one, when I arrived just now, was pleased to see me. I mean, you're my friends, right?
Neil, you've spent the past 2 years belittling us, calling us stupid, and acting like a complete up-himself dick. Don't you see? Don't you see that affects people?
It was all just a joke. I didn't mean any of it.
Like calling me a faggot.
I mean, a slut.
Just a joke.
Well, we're all going to the pub, if you want to come.
No, it's all right. You don't have to do that.
Oh, don't be daft. Come on.
Neil, results or not, we made it. We're adults, and that means leaving all this childish shit behind. You know?
Yeah.
So come on. Come to the pub. Have a pint. It's legal now.
Yeah. Maybe later. Lights up on an empty stage. A desk and chair center. A laptop. A boy sits typing. As he types, he talks. He's alone. There is no one with him, no one to talk to, no one to confide in. No action, just him, sitting, typing, for the longest time. Time passes, and yet more time passes, but no one comes. He's alone. Forever. But slowly, people start to emerge. Where there was once space, there are now people. One by one, they enter.
slowly filling up the world around him. The room is filling up with figures. He's no longer alone. He's no longer alone. The boy looks up and sees he is surrounded. And even though it's not real, even though he's conjured it from nowhere, and even though at any minute it could end and he'd be alone again, he's happy. For that moment, he's happy. Caused a major war just by talking. You flew into a rage, 'cause that's everything you know. Childhood of violence filled with heartache. I flew into a rage, 'cause that's everything I know. I know 100 ways to... But then, it's all over, and he's back where he started. A boy on the stage, alone. Alone.
Hey, Neil.
Oh.
Hey. Fancy a drink?
Oh, thanks, but... No, sorry. I'm working.
Cool. Anything good?
Oh, just something I'm trying.
Okay. Another time, then.
Yeah. Another time.
I